What's up, guys? Back with another one. I'm Ryan, my man George.
What's up, guys? I living out there.
Lost in Vegas, coming back at you. The unbiased real reaction, right, baby.
Shout out to the free thinkers, of course.
Yeah, man. So we got part two. Opeth, right?
Yep.
Part two. So if you guys haven't checked out the Dream Theater, check that out. That'll be in the description, right,
George? Right. So we got the Metal Progressive Tournament, right?
Yes, sir.
Our first metal tournament for progressive metal. We've already done, this is round one, Dream Theater versus Opeth. We already did the Dream Theater video. The link for that will be in the description. Check that out.
Yes, sir.
And now they're going up, and it was Dream Theater Pull Me Under, and now they're going up against Opeth, and it looks like
Blackwater Park.
Blackwater Park. We put a poll up on Patreon, right? Shout out to our patrons for voting. And Blackwater Park
one freaking vote, man.
I haven't even looked into the comments to know, because I know some fuckery going on in the comments. I know there's some mad people with one. I know it is. But we've kind of throughout the tournament, this tournament series that we're doing, because we've done we're doing currently the country tournament as well for Texas Red Dirt.
Yep.
We're trying not to really look in the comments too much.
Yeah.
Because we don't want that to kind of sway us in any way. At least until after the fact.
Right. Exactly.
When we're doing these videos. So I haven't looked into the comments, but we know that this is very close. And anytime it's really close like this, there's usually a lot of controversy in the comments. So,
yep.
Blackwater Part 1, every vote counts on Patreon.
And Deliverance was the second song on there that came in second place. That was Blackwater Park got 238 as far as votes. 238 votes, and Deliverance was 237.
Crazy.
So that was super duper close, man. And, you know, maybe it's something that we can kind of look at if Opeth gets to the next round in the tournament. Maybe we do Deliverance, man, as the next song, because it seems like there's a lot of sway with this song. It seems like there are a lot of people
that
want to hear
that. Let us know what you think of that,
though.
I mean, if you guys don't like that, let us know on Patreon. If that's not something you want to do, instead of us kind of putting up another poll and voting again, should we just do the second place song? Would you guys be okay with that? But just to kind of go over the songs, though, that were on the poll, just so everyone knows. So the first song we had was Reverie, Harlequin Forest.
Burden.
With 112 votes. Burden, In My Time of Need. Deliverance, Blackwater Park, of course, the winner. Sorceress, Drapery Falls, Masters Apprentices, The Grand Conjuration, and Moon Labs Vertigo. So those were the options on the poll. Blackwater Park won. We don't want to take too much time talking our asses off here. Just wanted to give you guys just an idea of how close those polls are on Patreon. If you're not on Patreon, you know, feel free to
check
join.
It out.
Man. It's dope. It's fun.
Yeah, man.
All right, cool. So let's get into it. Blackwater Park, Opeth, they got their work cut out for them.
Yeah,
Dream Theater's Pull Me Under was fire.
Pull Me Under is just incredible.
I'm just saying.
It's incredible.
Let's
man.
Get into it. Opeth, Blackwater Park.
The way that chord is so strong. I love that, man. I love the way that shit sounds.
Dude, again, I think I mentioned this before, man. They do such a good job. We're going to get the lyrics pulled up here in a little bit. Obviously, they haven't started with the lyricism.
Golly.
They do such a good job of setting a certain mood.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, this ominous mood. You know, so off the bat, this is going to... I just wanted to stop it because I can tell based off of how this started, unless this takes a turn for the worse, and at least in our opinion, it seems like this is going to be a very difficult decision between.
I'm telling you, man.
Dream Team. And we expected it, though. We
but you know, real quick, man, the way that they play that note, that that long like guitar note.
But those riffs, go ahead.
That's probably like the equivalent for me. How I love that is the equivalent of like bass in a hip hop song, like that low like. You're like, oh yeah, this is about it. It does something to my psyche, guys. I don't know what it is when I hear that
emotionally,
note.
Yeah,
I love the way that it's just so like raw and like it just brings the beast out of you, the Incredible Hulk out of you. You know what I'm saying? It's so like guttural. Like, yeah, boom, I just love it, man. I love the way that shit sounds.
I hear you, man. And I think that the way that they play those riffs, I feel like the way it's toned or just those riffs to me, I can pick those riffs out. I can pick that out, I swear. And yeah. I'm not even,
I got you.
Supporters of Opeth or fans. I don't support. Now it sounds bad. But I just don't want to say I'm a fan, guys. Long story. Watch the channel. You guys will understand that. But I feel like I could pick those riffs out. Like if it was 10 bands playing, I could say that's an Opeth riff. Like
I
those
got
riffs
you.
Are very distinctive.
Yeah, I got
to
you.
Opeth.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I noticed those same riffs in Ghost of Perdition.
Mm-hmm.
The same sound of those riffs in Bleak as well.
Yep.
So it's really the. Anyways.
Yeah.
This is going to be interesting, man. Let's keep it going. Yeah, so far, man. So good, though. I like how they rocked you into this. Though.
Yeah.
They rocked you the fuck out into that transition. We fucked up. Maybe we just weren't clear with what we like. I don't know. We should have got this shit.
Yeah.
First.
I'm telling you.
First.
Yeah, this dude. This shit is so fire, though, man.
This is crazy, dude.
This is so fire, man.
Already.
This is going to be a hard choice, man. If it keeps up at this pace, it's a 12-minute song.
This is. Listen, but I said I haven't been wild.
Godly, dude.
I said I haven't been wild in a video that we're probably not going to release. It's probably be exclusive to Patreon a band. But I think that I'm getting close to being wild here. You know what
dude,
I mean? This is crazy.
It's crazy. And you know what, man?
It doesn't
The growling
feel-
to me, it works right now. It works. That's what I'm saying.
I don't even notice it.
It works right now.
I don't
now.
Even notice it.
In this
particular song, I'm not noticing the growling. Go ahead, sir.
But no, you're good. I think we're going to say the same thing. Yeah. My point of saying that is the instrumentation, the musicianship in it is like mirroring that aggression.
Mm.
You see what I'm saying?
Okay.
It sounds the same to me. It sounds like, yeah, I'm about to fuck some shit up.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like I am like a time bomb about to explode. That's the kind of emotion this song brings out of me.
Yeah.
It's like, dude, This is hard.
But they did. But as far as the growls don't respond to that, they did let us rock out, though.
Yeah, they did.
Get into the groove before they introduced the growls.
Yes,
now, I don't
true.
Know if that was deliberate, but that probably is playing into why we're not noticing the growls as much because we were already in
like bobbing,
crazy,
like jamming.
Banging mode, right?
Yeah.
Before the growls got into the equation. So when they got them,
yeah,
I did that shit on purpose, man.
That shit was fire, though.
I'm just joking.
It's fire, man.
All right, we rocking, man. Let's keep going.
Fire. It is crazy.
Tough. It's an experience with this man, man. It's always an experience. Beautiful.
Yeah. Beautiful, man.
Not a wasted riff, man.
Dude.
Not a wasted
riff. It's beautiful. Beautiful.
This transition was excellent. So they rocked the hell out of you. Then they transition into this sort of beautiful arrangement that we're in now. It always seems to be just an experience.
It's a journey, man.
It's an experience. It's a journey,
yeah,
with Opeth and everything we've listened to. You know what I mean?
And I almost feel like you have to... Granted, this is the first listen for us, guys, so we're jamming out and we're enjoying it, but I really feel like to get the whole experience, and we're not even halfway through the song yet, I feel like you have to sit with it. I feel like you have to just sit there in a
But
room.
Not 100 times.
No,
and I'm
no,
going to
no.
stick with that.
No, no, I get it. No, I get it.
That's a joke for people who understand the channel, Ryan. For people who've seen the System of the Down song, when I was just like, you shouldn't have to listen to a song 100. No.
No.
I will never have to listen to a song 100 times to like a song. No.
Right, right.
I will always stick with that to my death.
Exactly.
I do think there is music, of course, that does require more
multiple
time.
Listening.
Right?
Multiple,
more time
multiple
for
listens.
You to sit with it, mm-hmm. take it in, absorb it. And I understand. It's
and
a
12-minute
song. You
yep.
know what I mean?
So, I think you need to do that with this. You have yep. to sit down almost like by yourself
yep.
and just listen to the various different instrumentation that they're and the journey that they're taking you on to fully like appreciate it.
Yep.
Now you can jam out, and that's what we do. We're jamming out right now, but I think that's the kind of journey that Opeth takes you on. I think you have to really sit with it and just listen to it and just almost like a college professor that would like, you know, be talking to his, you know, students and preparing for a speech.
Mm-hmm.
You have to sit with that shit and you got to practice and you've got to know how that's going to come across. Yeah. And I think that's the kind of preparation that this band goes into their music, man. So.
So far, so good. As yeah. we said, loving it. Let's keep it going.
To sleep, here we go. That's what it is. It's like, here we go. You thought I was gonna rock you guys to sleep, lullaby baby you? Nah, here we go. No, 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 wow. You know what I'm saying? We bring it right back. That's beautiful, man. That's beautiful. The way that they came in and out of that, man, that's beautiful, man. I mean, it came into out of the soft.
Reaching one of the best songs we've heard on the channel.
Dude,
status. It's
dope.
It's starting to,
dope.
It seems like it's going to crack that class of songs we've heard that we think are one of the best songs we've heard. So this is excellent. Let's keep it going.
Crazy. Yeah.
So they infused those odd, what seemed to be more of an odd
right.
time signature within the music.
But they finessed it. They finessed the game.
But it was well done to me. It was just smoothly executed.
And you know what, man, I mean?
In my opinion.
And you know, we had a conversation off camera, guys, George and I, and a lot of times, man. Certain things happen in life, whether you're talking about music or any kind of thing, any other various aspects in life, but specifically to music, every once in a while comes a band that will introduce something new and different. And then there's another band that takes that idea and takes it to a new level. And I think stuff like this, like Opeth, bands like this, they learn from their predecessors. Okay, there's the odd time signatures. Okay, that's kind of like the stamp of progressive metal. Okay, let's do that and let's finesse the shit out of it. Mm-hmm. Let's finesse the game, you know, mm-hmm. In my opinion. I mean, let me make that clear because I don't want people going crazy in the comments. But in my opinion, man, I just think that they finesse those transitions to on a different level, man.
Great. Let's keep it going.
My opinion. That's nasty. That is so nasty. God. That is filthy. That is filthy. I did not see that coming at all. I mean, I don't know. Dude, that was incredible. And I love that. I look, if anybody that watches the channel, you guys know I get excited when transitions come in. Smooth transitions. And that, I did not see that coming. That was incredible, dude. Nasty. That was filthy. I'm going to call it what it is. It was filthy.
I just stopped it to let you guys know that we thought, well, actually, y'all saw it. You guys saw what we thought of it.
Yeah, that was filthy.
It was disgusting, that transition. So let's get back to that.
Let's run that back.
Opeth fans, I mean, you guys have a reason to be pricks now. Not all Opeth fans, but there's been a few pricks in the comments.
Dude,
I get it. Yeah. I get it. You know, I've seen a hot chick, she's just hot, and it's like, you shouldn't be pretentious, you shouldn't be snobby, but...
But you are hot, though, is what you're saying.
I get it.
Man.
You're shallow as hell, and it's not a good thing to be shallow, but... By societal standards, you're the hot chick. I get it.
I tell you one thing, though, man. If you're into heavy metal, I don't know how you
again.
Don't
not
like
all
this.
Opeth fans, but there are a few.
Right, but I mean,
that was more of a joke. But
dude, this is
I get it though. Yeah, they're losing their minds.
They're putting on a clinic.
This is ridiculous.
It's a clinic, dude.
Let's keep it going.
Yeah.
That was special. That was special, guys.
Gots to be more careful. That was dope. That was dope, man. That was dope.
I don't want
to
give away who I think.
That was dope.
One, but
I don't think that that's a real fair comparison. I really don't, because this is a masterpiece. I really do. I think this is a more of a performance. I think this song live would be incredible. Incredible, you know? Now, and this is a thought that just came to mind when I was listening to this, man. It would be nice if maybe if you went to a rock concert or a metal concert, maybe they have two bands, you know, in that concert that play just little snippets of their songs. They play a little snippet of their song. You play a little snippet of your song. Kind of be like the equivalent of like a battle rapper. You know what I'm saying? I think that might be hot. Like, oh, okay, you think, you know what I mean? I think, and then you hit your little snippet and I hit my little snippet. I think that might be kind of hot.
Yeah.
That's a lot to choreograph and that's a lot to put together because you got a whole band. But the reason why I say that, to bring that full circle, is I don't think that that's a full comparison. If I'm comparing snippets of the Dream Theater song and snippets of this song, I think that would be more of a comparison, but I'll get more into that in the breakdown and analysis.
Yeah,
but
I mean, clearly the Pull Me Under was more of a commercial. I don't know if I would call that commercial.
Right.
But I can tell that's more commercial for Dream Theater versus this is just an epic.
Yes.
Like to me, this yep. I wouldn't be surprised if this is like a crown jewel of theirs. This to me,
it's incredible,
special like that. I was saying on another video that we have on Patreon and we may not be releasing to the public that I haven't been wowed in a while. I was wowed. That was incredible.
Mm-hmm.
I don't see how you could. Yeah.
Yeah.
Shout out to these gentlemen. They're from Sweden as well. I don't think have you ever mentioned that?
I don't think so.
Shout out to Sweden, man.
Yeah, I guess
shout
so.
Shout out to our subs in Sweden, man.
For
following the channel, man. Y'all got one, though, Sweden.
Yeah,
y'all
man.
Got something in Sweden. Woo. I don't know what's in the water, but damn.
Yeah, that is incredible.
That was excellent, man. Incredible. I'm not sure. We're probably going to get into the breakdown of what I got out of the lyrics here in the second part. You know, when we give our analysis and our conclusion on who we think should advance to the second round. Although it does seem like it's almost chronicling some sort of plague or pandemic that broke out in an area. So, but we'll get into the lyrics.
Yeah, man. So,
so,
yeah, so that's the end of the second video, because we're going to do this in two parts, because otherwise it'd be one long video. So check out the Dream Theater video, guys. That was part one of this tournament with the Dream Theater versus Opeth. And then we'll put this in the second video, right?
Yes.
And yeah, this will be Opeth.
We're constantly tweaking. I mean, people who are new to the channel don't know what the fuck is going on, but people who are following the channel, you guys are noticing we're just doing little tweaks until we figure out a system that we think works best for our new format. And so I think we're going to break. This is going to be its own video. This Opeth in the Dream Theater video that we just completed is going to be its own video.
Yes.
But it's a tournament. So they're kind of.
So they're going against each other. In the essence of saving time and not a long video, it's going to be Dream Theater is going to be one video. Yep. Opeth will be one video.
Yep.
But they're going against each other.
And then we're
going
to have another video where we do some call-ins with our subs.
Yes.
Right? And we also give our breakdown and our conclusion, but we'll have some call-ins where subs give us their opinion on who they think
won.
So,
yep, exactly.
You guys will know. If you follow the channel, if you haven't subscribed, subscribe, and then you'll figure it out.
Absolutely.
So that's it, guys. That's the end of the video of the first part, Group A in round one in the Metal Progressive the Progressive Metal Tournament. And that's it. If you guys enjoyed it, please hit that like button. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. And also, guys, check out our Patreon channel if you're interested. It will allow you to get early access to our content. The information for that will be in the description. I'm George. That's Ryan, Las Vegas.
We out.
Fucking my hat up, but we out.
We out.